So one of the ways we can use stem cells is stem cells can become any type of cell in the body. We just have to know how to direct them using certain factors or gene editing so we can make the cells that are lost in glaucoma. So the other way we're using stem cells is using them to regenerate the optic nerve. So normally retinal ganglion cells connect the eye to the brain, and in glaucoma that connection is lost. Using stem cells, we're able to regrow that connection by transplanting cells into the optic nerve and using the inherent qualities of stem cells to regenerate those connections and restore vision.
So we're here today at the 5th Annual Glaucoma Patient Summit in Long Beach, California. Joining me is...
My name is Jiun Do. I'm an assistant professor of ophthalmology at the University of California, San Diego, at the Shiley Eye Institute and the Viterbi Department of Ophthalmology.
Thank you for joining us. Can you provide an overview of your presentation at today's Glaucoma Patient Summit?
So my presentation, we were focused really on developing treatments to restore vision. And there have been multiple ways of doing that. The way that we're looking at here is using stem cells. And so the presentation involved how do we use stem cells to replace the cells that are lost in glaucoma, and how do we regenerate the optic nerve using stem cells. And so I think it's a very promising field. I think we're getting to the point where we're able to replace the cells and restore those connections and hopefully restore vision to patients.
I'm sure patients were inspired by your presentation today. What motivated you to focus on stem cell research in the context of glaucoma?
Yeah, I think that there's so many ways to be able to use the stem cells, as I think we've demonstrated with being able to make new cells and being able to transplant those to making these neural stem cell relays and regenerating the optic nerve. So I think it's the promise of the stem cells. And I think part of that is also having the resources to be able to do that, the collaborations, the people who have the expertise. And I think being able to work in a collaborative scientific team and having those resources available at UCSD have really been the inspiration for that. So one of the ways we can use stem cells is stem cells can become any type of cell in the body. We just have to know how to direct them using certain factors or gene editing so we can make the cells that are lost in glaucoma. So in glaucoma, you lose what's called retinal ganglion cells. And so using stem cells, we can make retinal ganglion cells. And some of my colleagues, Derek Wellesby and Carl Wallen, have been able to really work on that aspect of things. The other way we're using stem cells is using them to regenerate the optic nerve. So normally retinal ganglion cells connect the eye to the brain. And in glaucoma, that connection is lost. Using stem cells, we're able to regrow that connection by transplanting cells into the optic nerve and using the inherent qualities of stem cells to regenerate those connections and restore vision.
How do you collaborate with other researchers, clinicians, and institutions to advance the stem cell research?
Yeah, so definitely the stem cell research is a collaborative. There's just too much information and a lot of work that needs to be done. So we really have expertise in different aspects of things. So some people focus on differentiating the stem cells into retinal ganglion cells. Others are looking at neuroprotection. How do we protect the retinal ganglion cells that are there, or even make better retinal ganglion cells? In my work, we're working on the neural stem cell relay, and so there are different factors that we can include into our stem cell transplants and also different ways of looking at those connections as well. And so we really specialize in different aspects of it. It is a team effort, and so through meetings, through conferences, we really get those ideas going. And so even on weekends, sometimes there's always inspiration that hits you, and there's our moments of collaboration that you really look forward to.
In your experience, why are seed grants such as the Shaffer Grant so important when it comes to finding a cure for glaucoma?
I think the Schaefer Grant has been instrumental. It's able to identify someone with a promising idea. And sometimes you need a little bit of help to be able to get that preliminary data or that initial finding that you can do this type of work, that it shows promise, and it provides the resources to do those experiments, to collect that data, to write those papers, and then it propels you into being prepared to get grant funding from bigger agencies, such as the NIH or other private foundations as well. So it really has been instrumental, because it's at that critical phase where you're starting your career, you have a great idea, but you just need someone to believe in it to really help you collect the data that you need, and then to be able to present it to people and really get the ball rolling. And from there, you know, you find the collaborations with other people as well that have been associated with the Schaefer Grant or with the Glaucoma Research Foundation. And that's really, you know, it's a very natural way for those collaborations to come about.
Sounds like getting someone to take a chance on you when it's so early in the process is a little difficult. So I'm glad that you were able to find a Schaefer Grant.
No, definitely. Yeah. I think, you know, we're all very ambitious. And so it's nice to be able to work with a team with a very similar goal of being able to restore vision and treat patients.
Can you tell us a little bit about what your proposition was for the Schaefer Grant when you received it?
Yeah, so my proposition was really looking at if we could, you know, we had this idea of using these stem cells to create this neural stem cell relay. It's been used in spinal cord injury, but really spinal cord and the eye, very different systems. And so we were really investigating whether we could translate these neural stem cells to be used in the optic nerve to regenerate the optic nerve. And so with the Schaefer Grant, we were able to show that we can transplant this into the optic nerve. The stem cells survived, they integrated into the system, and they extended or connections all the way back to the optic nerve, optic chiasm. And so it really did provide that initial information, their data, that we're able to say, this is something promising, let's keep going at it.
That was great. Thank you for joining us so much today, for being a presenter, and for just being part of this event. I hope you've enjoyed it.
It was fantastic. I'd love to return. And I think, you know, it's a foundation that really is inspirational. And I think the collaborations that it makes has been key to moving the field forward.